quartet. There's lots of things that you're going to be asked to do. Who's the musical leader? Well, probably the guy that knows a little bit about music would be the best one. Who's going to run the rehearsal? Not necessarily the musical leader. Maybe another guy can run it. Everybody in the quartet should have some kind of responsibility. If it gets left on the shoulders of one guy, eventually there's resentment toward that guy. And he's been doing all the work all along, and now you don't like him because he made a decision or he assumed something that wasn't necessarily what you wanted him to do. Well, it's your own fault. You didn't take part of the responsibility. Who's going to be the business manager? How are you going to file this quartet? Are you going to set up a partnership through the IRS using SS4? Or are you going to just kind of float along and trust everybody to come up with their social security numbers at the right time? My recommendation is, if you're going to be doing a lot of shows, get the form SS4, file for your employer identification number, cost you nothing, and each year you just file a form 1065, which takes about 12 minutes to fill out and keeps you legal. That way when monies come into your treasury, you don't have to worry about my social security numbers on that. I got to chase these other three guys for their fair share. You don't get kicked into another income bracket. It's there. It's a quartet. Becomes an identity. Who's a contact man? That's different from the business manager. Contact man might be the guy that really knows how to handle people. Don't let your baritone do that.
All right.
I have an example of it anymore.
All right. That's a prime example of a baritone right back here. Baritone to me is like a guy who buttoned up his shirt and missed the first one, and you never quite get caught. What part do you sing, sir?
Please.
A librarian needs to exist in the quartet. May be the same guy as the music leader. May not. The spokesman. Who's gonna handle the onstage stuff? And how's he gonna handle it? And you're gonna give him a chance to rehearse that before he goes out? You better. Because I'm telling you right now, I've seen more quartets break up because a guy went out there and took some cheap shot at another guy's wife on stage as kind of a funny ha-ha, and he wound up missing teeth. How are you going to settle disputes when they come up in a quartet? My quartet has the 4-0 rule. If the vote isn't 4-0, then whatever it was that was proposed doesn't get done. If it's 3-1, that's not good enough. If it's 2-2, we're probably in real serious trouble. It's 4-0. Great story about that. We went to Sweden. And while we were in Sweden, we happened to go up by the palace. And we couldn't figure out in Stockholm why all these people were gathered around. And pretty soon these guys come running out with the funny hats and the shields and everything else. And you hear this bugle call. And here came the king and queen of Sweden in an open carriage, as close as you are to me right now. So G. Willikers, being ever alert and quick to react, saying, "Hi, neighbor," as they went by. And they just kind of, so now we tell everybody we appeared before the crown heads of Europe. which is true. But the funny part was, we went into the gift shop, and it was these cufflinks that had the royal crown of Sweden on it. And Gary Stamm saw the cufflinks, and he fell in love with them. They're like $200 cufflinks. And they had gold and ivory. I mean, we're talking real gold, real ivory, and real expensive in a country that was already too expensive. So we kind of looked at him, and we had the rule, you know, 4-0, or we don't get him. So Gary's lean, I said, "Nah, it's too much." And Gary said, "Okay." And you could see his chin kind of just, "Okay." And he started twitching. Gary has a very bad habit of twitching when he's not happy. But he understood, and he never complained about it. So we went outside, and the following day we had some other things to do. And Gary and Dave went up to the Hard Rock Cafe, and Del and I, after I talked to Del and Dave, Del and I sneaked back to the gift shop, and we bought 4 sets of the cufflinks. We did this show 2 days later in Nishepping, this little opera house, a wonderful place to sing, and Gary's in there putting on his black cufflinks, and the three of us had ours already on, hidden, a brand new one. And he made some comment about, "Sure would have been nice to have those classy Swedish cufflinks on." And I said, "Come on, you're not going to bitch about those cufflinks forever, are you? Let's just get past that." So as we get up, we walked over, I said, "By the way, you're out of uniform." And he says, "How's that?" Of course, the three of us came in with our hands out like this with the cufflinks. He saw them, we gave him the cufflinks, and there was the old 4-0. And Gary Stamm just was one happy camper. It's not much of a story, but it's, you know, it's just kind of a camper, the way we settle things. How do you settle disputes in the quartet? Well, there's lots of ways. Is one guy going to be the decision maker? and everybody goes to him. It is done in some quartets. You're going to have a coach help you with that? Can be done. An outside party to act as a mediator. Another third party, simple majority, 4-0. You need to know how these disputes are going to be settled before you ever have your first real quartet rehearsal. Are there any personal traits that can cause problems? Drinking is usually a good one. You can't have a guy in there that's a non-drinking teetotaler and another guy who really likes to bolt them down, or you've got a problem. My big problem with one of the guys that I sang with in a quartet was he used to like to drink in the dressing room before we went on. And to me, that was absolutely out of the question. Out of the question. If it wasn't water, I didn't want to hear about it. We worked it out. I hit him. seemed a bit. You know, are there any personal hang-ups? Can you maintain the friendship? Are we going to include the wives and sweethearts in our travels and our plans and so forth? Who's going to pay the individual dues for the members of the quartet? And does each guy get the same amount for his dues, even though he might belong to different chapters and the dues are different? You know, there are lots of questions that you need to sit down and really take into consideration for the good of the quartet as an entity. And if you take the time to do that, you're going to find your quartet will last a whole lot longer than 1 or 2 years. The average life of a quartet in our society is probably 2 years. That's the second time they go back to an A&R, and the sound judge goes, That's about when they kind of start sliding away, and they find other things to do. There's more to it than contests, but there's an awful lot in this particular agreement that you ought to know about, and you ought to take a look at. This agreement, by the way, was prepared by a very, very fine quartet man by the name of Dick Treptow. Dick Treptow was the second baritone of the Happiness Emporium.
Baritone, see? Our boy, Bob.
Dick had lots of people in his family to help. He wrote it with crayon, and we managed to get it. He's very happy now. Sunnydale is a nice place for him to be. I have some copies over here with a number of people in the Whittier chapter that are obvious with the colors that they're wearing and so forth. If you take one or two of these, I'd appreciate it. And let at least one person from each chapter or quartet get another one for them. Yes?
Just one comment. I know when our quartet was first, before we ever organized, Ron and I got together and we auditioned. But we had a very important function as our goals, and make sure that all four guys has got the same goal.
The highlights of this thing. What type of quartet are we interested in singing in? Show, competition, comedy, fun, semi-professional, other, combination of above. Individual goals for quartetting. I mean, all the stuff is in there. And you can sit down with this document with four guys and spend 3 hours and never cover it. And be absolutely amazed at what you begin to learn about each other outside of the music. And once all of that has been placed and understood and agreed upon, the music is easy. The things that get in the way of the music aren't singing wrong notes. The thing that gets in the way of the music is individual personalities. And we need to get rid of some of those little hang-ups. This is one way to attempt to do that. And I think you'll find it very useful. Any other questions or comments about that? Good. I also brought some forms with me that deal with that form SS4 that I was talking about, so you'll understand how to set up a partnership. And I gave you some examples in here of what the form looks like when it's filled out. I included an easy way to keep your business records by showing you a cover page of a Dome bookkeeping record that has everything you ever wanted to know and were afraid to ask, which is all legal, ways to record your expenses. And I walked you through a few things in here. And there's examples in here of Form 1065 to show you how easy that is to fill out. And a dummy projection from some dummy quartet called G. Willikers. And if you want, pick up one of these as well. These are even more limited. And please, if you pick them up and you want to make additional copies, please feel free. From a business end of a quartet, there are lots of things that you really, really, really need to understand when forming it. Now, before we move on to other stuff and have a quartet sing, are there any questions about formation or getting together idea parties for how to get up and running? Yes, sir.
How do you come together musically? You didn't really talk about that.
Musically?
Yeah.
Musically is really the easiest part. If you got four guys that are get along and agree on the goal, they'll figure out the music stuff. It's the other things that get in the way. You know, do you have to have the world's greatest tenor? Well, maybe not. But if the quartet will agree that that tenor can get some help at a particular voice coach and is willing to pay for it, it can help make that tenor very, very successful. I've never worried about the musical part. I kind of looked around for the people I wanted to sing with. Yeah. And one time I wound up with, I was singing bass, and I found the lead that I wanted. The other two guys were both tenors. And we mugged one and made him a baritone. But voice parts were the last thing that we were really worried about. We just took care of all the other details first. Anybody else? We got a quartet here, right? Want to hear some singing?
Yeah.
Yeah. Four guys like to do some singing. Why don't we start with just four guys who like to sing? I need a lead. One lead. This is not a time to be bashful, guys. This is the group participation part. It doesn't get any better than this. One lead. Doesn't even have to be a good lead. Well, you can go. One lead.
Go ahead.
One lead.
Is to find three other parts to sing with. I need one tenor.
You got one.
One tenor. Okay, we got a tenor. I need a bass. One bass.
You're
going to
sing.
Well, I'm not going to sing. You're going to sing. I need a baritone. Okay, let's... Dean, I will make a stipulation and say good baritone.
Damn, Dean.
Okay, gents.
Enemies.
You've got exactly 15 seconds to decide on the song. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 0.
Will the Lord
Shine on me in the evening. Shine on me. I wonder if the
singing, tell me. I mean, I don't read minds. I don't even talk very good.
I've noticed that.
Thank you so much. Sometimes when I'm back talking, it's too many Dingles peep, I'm drunk. Actually, I've had too many martinis and a watch and Scott or two and a drunk rice dandy, the longer I get.
That's easy for you to say.
So sits on you, Pista. What do you say?
That bothers me. Yeah, it is.
Watch out. Lighting is not strong enough for that camera to be able to handle all that in the back there.
I wanted to talk to somebody about that.
Oh, okay.
You got a lot of reflection.
I guess the best thing to do there would be to invite, the Rusty Roosters? The Rusty Roosters.
Most contests have two songs.
Two. This is what I like to do.
Tell a great deal about it.
We've had one quartet in the Northeastern District called Pandemonium. What kind of quartet is it?
Beautiful.
Comedy. You bet your life it is. And everything they do creates absolute pandemonium. There are other quartets that show up at International. You know, every time I see a quartet with a name like Sound Assurance, it's a nice name, but it doesn't really do anything to set them aside from all the other quartets, nor does it make an impact upon a potential audience somewhere else. So what we need to do is become a little bit more careful in the way we select the name and realize that there are 35,000 barbershoppers and there are nearly 300 million Americans.
How many registered quartets are there?
Right now we have approximately 1,900 registered quartets. Never try to register the Eight Balls of Harmony, by the way. I don't care how funny it is. They won't give it to you. How did you happen to pick your contest songs?
Well,
how did you happen to pick your spokesman?
I have the money in my bank account.
No, seriously, there is a natural progression as to how things get done in a quartet, and nobody ever talks about it. And the organization of a quartet either seals your fate or makes you successful beyond your wildest dreams before you ever sing a note. Just knowing what you're going to do, knowing who you are, being comfortable with who you are. This is it, pal. This is the whole package. This is the way I've been since before I went to work for the staff, and this is what they have to put up with on a daily basis ever since I went to work for the staff. No different. A little different. I used to make a salary. How'd you pick your songs?
We all picked them.
Everybody had a selection of stuff.
So sort of lay it on a table and discuss?
Yeah, we just kind of figured out which one to do.
Okay.
I wanted to make sure they were, contest songs.
Okay. It might be a nice idea if the song that you DQ, if you're going to go to a contest, know that in advance. Maybe run it by someone like an arranger. Or look at the voicings of the song and make sure everybody in the quartet can handle it. Yeah, I love those high C's. Best Mike tenor can hit is a B flat, but I love those high C's. Or is it within the range and the ability of the quartet to sing it? Picking music just because you like the song may be the worst reason in the world. You ought to be able to sing it with some degree of quality if that's what you're going to do. And not just contest stuff, but show stuff as well. Yeah. So how you pick your spokesman, how you pick your name, how you pick everything that goes on with the quartet should have some rhyme or reason. And you should have some kind of direction that you're going to go with it. You know, some quartets can sing ballads. Oh, that's all I'm interested in. Just sing ballads. That's what we're a ballad quartet. And that's wonderful if they want to go only into contests. But if they put together a package that's got nothing but ballads in it, I'm heading for the door after the third one. Maybe not even the third one. Maybe the second one.
Yeah, there you go.
If I don't like the first one, I may not last with the introduction to that either. So you gotta be careful how you make these selections and what goes on. What other unusual things you want in your quartet that you
Well, rehearsal times are one of them. Since none of us are, Dean here has to work the golf course every once in a while. None of us are gainfully employed, so yesterday we rehearsed it in the morning. We can rehearse it, almost any time.
It was easy to pick a contact man because Dean Taylor said to me, I want you to be the contact man. So I said, fine.
And the other two guys had no vote in that?
They were sitting there and they agreed with him.
Sure. That's fine.
Wasn't that a big deal?
Some guys it is. I sang in a quartet one time and we changed leads and our new lead was a gold medal winner. And I had always been the contact and I had always been the quartet whip. And in walks Dick Chakas, the quartet, as the new lead. And I said, this ain't going to work. So I got together with Dick after the first night that we had talked about it. He and I went down to the restaurant, had a cup of coffee. I said, let's lay it right on the table. I've always been the contact man. I've always done this. What do you see yourself handling the best? He says, if you think I want the job as quartet contact man, you're out of your mind. What I want to do is run the musical end of the rehearsals. I said, fine, no problem. But we talked about it before it happened. The greatest thing that will tear your quartet apart is internal festering. lasting resentment when two guys will talk about you on the phone without ever talking to you directly. If you can head all of that off, man, you're better off. Or three guys get together and decide, well, we could really go somewhere if we had a real base. Yeah, and they start shopping around. And pretty, you know, you can't keep those kinds of things secret. Put down on that little agreement, like I said before, how will a quartet come to an end? If it reaches a point that three of them are really gung-ho for contest, and the other guy just ain't cutting it, and they're honest enough to say, hey, we love you like a brother, but we want the gold, and you can only take us to maybe mic test it. We want another base. There's nothing wrong with that, provided you're up front about it. It is now time for Mr. Gassman to make his ever-popular and quick, short announcements.
Look at my watch more often. We will break at about 9 and take maybe 5 or 10, so you can find a place to smoke if you want to, or go out to the bathroom, or whatever you want to do. Some people smoke, John. Not very many, but some do.
I don't smoke, John.
I don't even talk to John. I just point at him.
John, you smoke anybody.
So Bob Nyman had a few announcements to make. We'll come back at, say, 9, 10 or so, and Mutual Fun is here. Quartets who have sung and will sing again, they'll be out as well, and we'll maybe do some more singing and more exciting words of wisdom. I have to say that because he's still here from Ev now. First is Bob Nyman.
Two administrative announcements. The restroom, is about where that refrigerator is, but in the next building, and you don't get in from the inside, you get in from the outside, and it is unlocked. Secondly, would you please sign in on the sheets in the back? There is one sheet there for those who have been here before, and all you have to do is put a little X. If you have not been here before, there's a second sheet. We would appreciate your signing in on. I'd be remiss as show chairman of Whittier Chapter if I didn't plug our show. We've got a great show this year, featuring Panache, the ladies champs, and Nightlife, the district men's champs, and your father's mustache, there he is himself.
Never heard of him.
Two shows at Whittier High School, April 17th on a Saturday, a matinee at 1 p.m. and an evening show at 8, and two shows at La Mirada Civic Theater, April 22nd and 23rd, that's a Thursday and Friday. There are flyers on the back table. Feel free to take them. If any of you know now that you want tickets, we can give you some hot ones over the phone, or just talk to Malcolm Lincoln or me here tonight. Now, I've got an important announcement, and it's kind of an exciting announcement for us. You may remember that 2 years ago, the Russian quartet, the Quiet Dons, came over and toured the United States. They were sponsored by, well, around here, by Pete Nuschel and the 139th Street Quartet. They're coming back again in late July and August for a 2.5-week tour of California only. The 139th asked us the other night, asked Whittier, if we would be willing to put on a presentation with them, with the Russians, the 139th, and the Whittier Chorus. And we jumped at the chance, so I want to announce right now that we will put on a performance at La Mirada Civic Theater Friday night, August 13th at 8 p.m. And there's a sheet back there if you're interested, if you want flyers, or if you think you might want tickets. We'll give you first crack at them, just indicate there. No commitment, just indicate that you might be interested, and I'll get in touch with you. Again, our show in April, and the Russians, August 13th. Any questions?
Where is one of the quartets? It was the first quartet we had up here, the first of the two quartets.
Two regulars.
Called Quartet Number One. Quartet Number One was very, they were baritone driven, and then they came up with Quartet Number One. No. Let's see. I think they call them the Table Smashers, I'm not sure.
Red coat, two red coats.
Now, we asked them to sing extemporaneously before. Now we ask them to sing impromptu ahead of rehearsal. See if there's anything that you notice that they do different. I'm curious. See if there's anything different.
Their bass has a hormone for it.
and true my gal to you. You're the honey that I love so well. Look eyes, I love you. Little eyes, I love you. Love you in the spring and in the fall.
Honey, 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 honey.
Little eyes, I love you. Little eyes, I love you. Love you best of all.
Honey, 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 honey.
Little eyes, I love you. Little eyes, I love you. Love you in the spring and in the fall.
Honey, 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 honey.
Little eyes, I love you. Little eyes, I love you. Love you best of all.
Honey, 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 honey.
Honey that I love so well.
You just sing. They got the problem. You got it easy.
Oh, honey, honey.
Okay, let's stop again. Stop and start again. Move backwards just a little bit so you can be a little closer but not be able to see each other. Now listen to your lead.
Oh, honey.
Okay, step out just a second, lead. I want to show you what you're doing. One of the reasons that they didn't come in with you was you weren't giving them any kind of target. You were going, oh, ready guys, sing with me, ready? Four of you, I'm the lead now.
Oh,
I'm saying,
yeah.
Now watch, I can bring them with me if I can breathe a little smarter and yeah, I can follow. Ready? Here we go, guys.
Oh, honey, honey.
Let's sing off the top of the breath. You try that.
Oh, honey, honey, bless your heart. Oh, honey that I love so well, so well.
You do it fine, do that.
I've done been true, my gal, to you. You're the honey that I love.
This does a lot of things. It makes them listen to each other a little bit more and makes them begin to get in touch with each other as a quartet. It also does something else. Four of you turn around and face me, would you? Okay? You ever watch quartets where the lead feels compelled to have to do this all the time?
Yeah.
There's a karate fight going on below the belts. Oh, honey, honey, bless your heart. Even directs the scoop in there, right? If you got a quartet where the hands are the problem, maybe the problem is a lack of confidence. Maybe we can solve the confidence problem by taking away the sight factor altogether and making them listen. Now, if I'm standing out here waving my hands, I'm an idiot because nobody can see it anyway. Let's make them sing rather than try to do all the things that you think quartets do. Because the stuff that you think quartets do have become caricatures of quartetting in itself. And we look stupid to the general public when we do stuff like that. We look absolutely. You ever see people imitate barbershop quartets? They don't imitate what we are. They imitate what they think we are based upon what we've done to promote that. We need to clean up our act a little bit. Let's rehearse smarter to take away some of the ticks. And start right off the bat. As soon as you took the breath, could you hear him?
Yeah.
Much easier for you to sing. All he's going to do is follow. All you've got to do is lead. Okay, a round of applause. Quartet. Well, what's quartet number one without quartet number two? This is called the Smothers Brothers.
You got lost, Larry.
Nobody.
Oh,
here he comes.
You're a leader. You're supposed to lead us.
We got so successful that we changed the
game.
Come along to the sugar cane, do the hurry-arty-go-way.
Now get your ticket and we'll have a wonderful spree.
Down south,
down at the Sugar Cane Jubilee.
Jubilee. There is a place.
What a place.
Where
every face
is bright and gay.
Bright and gay. Bring yourselves some money, boy.
sing the number and you can do the buck and wing. Sing any sad song you want to hear me sing. Just name your pleasure, dig down in your jeans. Cause my body needs a beverage and my guitar needs new strings. Well, I'm a song and dance man. Come gather round and come and clap your hands. Bring your tears, boys, put them in the old tin can. Buy me a drink, boys, and do a little bit of the old soft shoe. Put a little something in the kitty, and I'll sing and dance for you. Caught pneumonia while I'm standing in the corner of the rain. But I found heaven at a little place in New Orleans. Hey, Jason woman, love me till I got strong. Then I rolled that freight train out of her heart, and I wrote about this song. Put a little something in the kitty, and I'll sing and dance. Sing and dance all night.
Yes, we are Mutual Fund, and the reason that we're called Mutual Fund was we couldn't think of another name besides I sell them for a living. So I have two kinds of business cards tonight, folks.
Take your pick.
Let me tell you, brother, somebody else is taking my place. Somebody else now shares your embrace. While I am trying to keep from crying, you go around with a smile on your face. Little you care for the vows that we made.
Young lady. I was 18 again.
Oh, how I wish I was 18 again.
And going where I've never been. But old folks and old oaks standing tall just pretend. And I wish I was 18 again. Time turns the pages and life goes so fast. The years turn the black hair to gray. I talk to the young folks, they don't understand the words this old man got to say.
Oh,
I wish I was 18 again.
What they were doing. Did it show?
Yeah.
You bet you like the show. and it wasn't pretentious for the most part. Some nervousness came through, didn't it? In certain spots. Where did the nervousness come through the most?
Bad start.
Between each of the songs, there was a perceptible lack of continuity to their act, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So my advice to them would be, okay, now that you've got the songs, each of those songs is going to be, you know, it's like a little balloon. You fill it up with words and notes and interpretation and stage presence and gimmicks and one-liners, and you tie off the balloon and you put it over here and you learn the next song. Well, somebody better find a way to start holding those balloons together before they go off in different directions. Their act went off in different directions in a lot of ways. And one of the things that they need to work on is ways to get the pitch to get into the songs so that they know where it's going to come from without making a big deal about it. Their pitch technique is very obvious because that's the way they
rehearse too much time.
What?
Waste too much time.
Yeah, a lot. And when you had the problem, there was an opportunity. Now, you've got a built-in area here for something that went wrong, but no way to cover it. What would have happened while he was fumbling with the pitch over here to get, who was it asked for? You? You asked for the pitch again?
Yeah.
Okay, it's okay to ask for the pitch again. That's going to happen. But wouldn't it be nice if we anticipated that problem might have happened and some guy stepped out over here and kind of hit it and said, hey, welcome to our rehearsal, or something to break that little moment where everybody was very anxious about what this dude was up to. Yeah. And the other three guys are going, get the goddamn pitch.
Who is
this?
What's the
first word?
First of all, that pneumonia gag in the opening song, that's hot stuff. That was, I thought you really were going to sneeze here for a second. I really honestly did. And the more believable it is, the better. The hand clap stuff, is there supposed to be a running gag for this?
Yeah, we're trying to do a running gag.
It may need to start off, who's the foil? Who's the guy that can't get it?
Bart, right?
Yeah. The deal ought to be, in all likelihood, you may want to pick one guy and let him be the focal point for the problem. Mm-hmm. And make it so that at the beginning it's sort of like, and the other three guys kind of, you know, first in a while it just and then it gradually as it goes along, let the deterioration of the one guy overpower the rest of the guys until eventually the three of them can't do it and you do it perfectly. That's one way to go. Another way to go would be to continue to try to help them through the gag. But right now, it becomes very disjointed. I'm not sure whether you really know it or you're screwing around on purpose or you're going to just have
it. We never do it the same way twice.
There's another problem. It's got to be the same way every time, but you got to create the illusion of the first time each time that you do it. And when you come up with that illusion for the first time, You ever go see Rural Route 4? Talk about the illusion of the first time. When he does that gramophone bit, I mean, everybody in the world knows it's coming. And you laugh every single time. The timing is good. The delivery is wonderful. And all of these illusions that he brings, all these memories he brings back of kicking the record player when grandma wasn't around and all that stuff. Yeah, I can see that. You've got to do the same thing with the hand clap so that this character or these characters are very, very believable in their reactions.
No, it's obviously we've been witchheading. He really has had
to
plan and practice rehearsals.
That's okay. Yeah. This is something that
that's a goal.
We'll work on that and get it out.
But we just need
you have great eyes.
What? Gates, so we like to rehearse.
Oh,
you want gates? The first thing is. Somebody else has taken my place, and the why are you again? Do you have any costume ideas for that?
No.
You ever watch The Village People? Where they used to do the YMCA thing? Yeah, well, I tell you, in this town, if you were to pull off a quick costume change with an Indian headdress and all of that, and do a why are you like The Village People, you'd tell them. You'd ask them, forget I brought that one up, folks.
East Coast, Joe.
The Village People? You guys don't know The Village People?
Oh, yeah.
No, sure.
Yeah.
YMCA.
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 I remember. I just remember the bit. Huh?
Well, he's the wife.
Bunch of 12 fellas.
Never mind. It wasn't that important. The between song stuff. You got to pick a guy to the center of each one. Like the Lewing effect of the George Burns issue. Where didn't Judge Stroke write that?
I appreciate it with Sonny something.
Oh, I thought it was Judge Stroke.
No, he wrote something similar to it. I'll think of the name of it in a minute.
Bring You a Daisy and Dave.
That's it.
I thought he wrote that one too because they came out talking about the same time. Anyway, the guy who sets up the songs in between, the other three guys have got to learn to how to relinquish and so forth. You can create a great deal better presence for each of the songs if the three guys who are not speaking would get back and do something believable to draw attention to the speaker. The shifting around was woodshedding too. And in a rehearsal, you need to tie that part of it as well. On the 18, I Wish I Was 18 Again, start that song again. Now, you're up front, right? Yeah. You guys are Louie. Now you've got a 3-on-1. We have what here we call a T formation, okay? During the course of the song, there is an opportunity to change this formation altogether. And as he goes into the second chorus, if he were to come over here, work across the mic this way, and those three guys were to profile the other way, you could set up an entirely different look, but also provide visual growth to the song as it went along. But what they did was they chose to leave him here with three guys behind. Now, when the other guy comes out and does his solo later on with a short, fat sheet of Arabi, they get the same look. Different guy, same look. We need to create a little visual variety. So this time through, kind of watch me, see if you can kind of get the idea, maybe drift over here, work across, and you three guys profile a little bit, like 3-on-1, right? Start off the way you were. See if it makes a difference.
A little song that George Burns sang, and you know, when I grow up, I want to be just like George.
At a bar down in Dallas, an old man chimed in, and I thought he was out of his head. But he and a young man had just left it off when I heard what the old man had said. He said, I'll never again turn the young lady's head and go running off. Waters home from the start to the end, and I wish I was 18 again. Oh, how I wish I was 18 again, and going where I've never been. An old coach and old oak standing tall just pretend, and I wish I was 18. Time turns the pages and life goes so fast. The years turn the black hair to gray. I talk to the young folks, they don't understand the words this old man's got to say. Oh, how I wish I was 18.
Let's have a little closure to this thing. Let's have him step over, and since you're all singing the words, the three of you step up and form a quartet again.
How time turns the pages and life goes so fast. The years turn the black hair gray. I talk to the young folks, they don't understand. I was 18 again, Lord, I...
Let the three guys take a regular bow. Boom. Okay? And as you start to take the bow, just kind of
give it one of these and just finish it.
Hey, Em, you have no idea how appropriate that is.
As far as staging ideas, you don't have to have dancing. You don't have to have a lot of complicated movement. A simple travel layer was able to involve more of the audience and give a different look. Now, if this guy wants to come out and do La Cucaracha while standing on his head, it'll be effective because we will have provided an opportunity for that solo to be different visually from this one. And those are the things that you need to look out for. The subtle things. Never mind making them too complicated. Just keep them simple, and it'll be much more effective. Yes, sir?
Yeah. Suppose the mic is in the center now.
Work across it.
Work across it. But it's going to pick him up.
Come here.
You got, I'm going to be the mic.
Just hold your hand right there. There's the mic. Most mics today are omnidirectional. So if he starts here, and if he's smart as he's moving, he can move this way and still be across that mic and be in the pickup pattern. Sure he will. He can be as close as he needs to. And with a voice like he's got,
his voice is
he has a very, very big voice.
Every time you made a move with him, it gave a different sound pattern. And every one of the different sound patterns was attractive. It caught a different.
Okay, but it also keeps them focused for the time being on something different is happening, and they tend to bear down on what they know better. I don't know what it is about simple travel that does that, but it does. Yeah.
I was going to say, if you have a problem with a mic like that, he could travel just a little bit, and the other three could travel just the opposite direction. It only takes half the steps that he is taking to travel.
Right.
But you get the same illusion.
You can minimize.